All right, let me set up this video. I just recently got a drone. I've also recently had a neck fusion, a three-level fusion, so I can't really look up and down. So all the flying you see on these videos, this one and the ones to come, will be looking through goggles. So basically sitting in a chair looking at one spot and controlling the drone. So I'm going to go ahead and play the video here. And today with my neighbor, I walked through the woods and we went and had a look at my pond. I hadn't been back to the pond in a long time, and there was a lot of fish just right up at the surface, little baby bass and such. So I figured I would fly back there. And when you fly in this drone, it's got sensors all around it. So it'll start beeping. Here I am going underneath some limbs. That's an alarm system. I'm looking at a radar screen and I can see that it sees stuff right and left and up and down when I was going underneath the tree limb. And here we're just gonna walk out over the water. Now I'm hovering over the pond. I'll try to see if we can see any fish. Now the noise you're hearing now, that's a fan blowing into goggles. And for some reason it sounds really loud on here. It's not that loud when you're in it. But I tell you, looking at this through the goggles, you're completely immersed. It's like, hell, it'll make you dizzy. It is unreal. Now, I've been flying RC. I probably flew for 10 years, but that was 15, 20 years ago. This is completely different. This is not like flying RC. I'm completely line of sight. I can't see this drone from where I'm at. I'm probably 500 yards away. With RC, you were flying the entire time and you had to keep your eye on it. It was pure line of sight. And even if it was first person video on an airplane, you still have to fly it constantly. You can't just let go of the sticks if you get in trouble and it'll correct itself. Not so with drones, or at least this drone. If you get in trouble, you're about to crash, just let go of the sticks. It will slide to a stop and maintain its level. Here we're going under the tree limbs again. And I think I might have even clipped that little couple of those leaves off the top. I couldn't really tell. But now I'm gaining altitude and going to pull up over the field. But again, like I said, if you get in a situation here with the drone, you can simply let go of it. And that happened to me several times. This is the second time I've flown it. So I don't know what to say about that. I still get kind of lost in the sky when I go way up high and get out over the trees. Okay, that warning means your battery is going dead. So what it will do, it will, if you don't respond to it and start coming home, it'll do it for you. So I'm starting to come on down here. Let me turn this down a little bit. But again, flying this drone is so easy. And this drone is the Mavic 2 Pro. And what you don't see is this camera is completely gyro-stabilized. So when I'm flying fast and I got it bank turn, you don't get any of that sensation because the camera's stabilized. I'm wondering if there's a way to turn that off to where I can be more of a pilot view and know when the drone is being banked and different stuff at high speed. But of course, I guess that's to come. But in landing mode, it'll actually bring it right back to where you took it off from within a foot or two. And landing. And she has such a sweet voice. Okay, I guess that's it for this little clip. I'll throw it up there, and if you like drone video, let me know.